One check. 'Cause in the desert of temptation lies the storm of true conversion.
Thank you.
here because I got some good friends coming, and they may, parents may be here to see them. So, okay. Thank you. When you're done, you just come around and come on up, and I'll put you right here. And
then I have a selfie.
Okay, great. Then we'll have a backup. That'll be good. Hi there, how are you? Come on up. Why don't you stand right here? Who else is coming today? Okay. Okay, so I'm going to put you two here, the two boys, and then Catherine can stand with you. All right. Do you guys know 40 days? 40 days to wander, 40 days to die the same. So this will be yours, and this will pick you up just fine. So you just leave your song sheet there. That's fine. And you're doing the greeting, so when you get done,
I don't know.
Good morning. Today is Wednesday, March 23rd, the third week of Lent. In today's first reading, Moses tells his people to observe and teach the generation to come all that God commands. And in the gospel, Jesus assures his disciples that he comes not to abolish the law, but to fulfill it. He tells them to obey and teach these commandments, to live in the kingdom of God. May we all strive today to hear the word of God and observe it. Please stand and join us in the response. Hold us in your mercy.
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 In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
What a joy it is for us to be together as God's people around the table of God's word and altar. And today, as we prepare to celebrate these sacred mysteries, let us acknowledge our sins.
Kyrie eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
Christe eleison.
Christe eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Let us pray.
Grant, we pray, O Lord, that schooled through Lenten observance and nourished by your word, through holy restraint we may be devoted to you with all our heart.
and be ever united in prayer. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Deuteronomy. Moses spoke to the people and said, "Now, Israel, hear the statutes and decrees which I am teaching you to observe, that you may live and may enter in and take possession of the land which the Lord, the God of your fathers, is giving you. Therefore, I teach you the statutes and decrees. The statutes and decrees, as the Lord my God has commanded me, that you may live, that you may observe them in the land you are entering to occupy. Observe them carefully, for thus will give you evidence of your wisdom and intelligence to the nations, who will hear of all these statutes and say, 'This great nation is truly a wise and intelligent people.' For what great nation that has gods so close as the Lord our God is to us whenever we call upon him? Or what great nation has statutes and decrees that are as just as this whole law which I'm setting before you today? However, take care and be earnestly on your guard not to forget the things which your own eyes have seen, nor let them slip from your memory as long as you live. But teach them to your children and to your children's children, the word of the Lord."
Thanks be to God.
The responsorial psalm is, "Praise the Lord, Jerusalem."
Praise the Lord, Jerusalem.
Glorify the Lord, O Jerusalem. Praise your God, O Zion. For he has strengthened the bars of your gates. He has blessed your children within you.
Praise the Lord, Jerusalem.
He sends forth his command to the earth. Swiftly runs his word. He spreads snow like wool. Frost he strews like ashes. He has proclaimed his word to Jacob, his statutes and his ordinances to Israel. He has not done thus for any other nation. His ordinances he has not made known to them.
Praise the Lord, Jerusalem.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus said to his disciples, Do not think that I have come to abolish the law or the prophets. I have come not to abolish, but to fulfill. Amen, I say to you, until heaven and earth pass away, not the smallest letter or the smallest part of a letter will pass from the law until all things have taken place. Therefore, whoever breaks one of the least of these commandments and teaches others to do so will be called least in the kingdom of heaven. But whoever obeys and teaches these commandments will be called greatest in the kingdom of heaven. The Gospel of the Lord.
Okay, so sometimes we get something new, but has to be put together. And how many of y'all have tried to put something together and it was kind of hard to figure out how to do it? Anybody had that experience? Yeah, you ever seen your parents try to put something together and they couldn't figure it out? So when I get something new, sometimes I just start trying to put it together. And they have this little thing called instructions, right? You ever seen those little instructions? And sometimes I have to go and look at the instructions to figure out how to do it. And sometimes we don't know how to live life very well without God's Word to give us instruction. God created us a certain way, but we forget how God created us sometimes. And Moses today, I love this moment. So Moses, he's on top of Mount Nebo, big tall mountain, I've been there, looking out across where the Salt Sea is, the Dead Sea down below, over toward the Promised Land. And that's where the book of Deuteronomy, which we heard from today, takes place. And we heard today God saying through Moses, these are my instructions for the people when they get to the land of promise. This is how you live. And if you listen to these words of mine, you will discover life and happiness. But if you don't listen to these instructions, you're gonna suffer. It's like me with all those parts of something new. I haven't read the instruction book, and I'm suffering trying to figure out how to put it together. And Jesus said today, I did not come to abolish the law or the prophets, but to fulfill them. You know what's sometimes better than an instruction guide? Somebody who knows how to put it together, who's done it before, right? That's why we need Jesus, right? He is God's life, God Himself made present to us. And He shows us how to be fully human, doesn't He? He's the perfect, fully human man. He shows us all of our humanity, fully alive. And so we know how we are called to live when we look at the way He lives life. So the next time you get something new and you're tempted to try to put it together without following the directions, you might remember God has also spoken to us and given us good directions on how to live. With trust in the Lord, let us bring our prayers of intercession.
Please respond, Lord, hear our prayer. For Pope Francis, Bishop Spalding, Father Mark, and all the clergy, may God continue to bless them with the spiritual and physical strength they need to care for his people. We pray to the Lord. For the salvation of the world, may the good news of Christ reach every corner of the earth and open hearts to his message. We pray to the Lord. For those who are sad or alone, lost or afraid, may God grace them with his comforting love and inspire others to reach out to them. We pray to the Lord. For those in his faith community who dedicate themselves to serving others, may God strengthen their commitment and fill them with his compassion. We pray to the Lord. For those who have died, may God welcome them into their eternal home with him in heaven. We pray to the Lord. For Laura Kreese, for whom this Mass is being offered, we pray to the Lord.
And for all the intentions that we hold in the stillness of our hearts, let us pray to the Lord. O God of all people, of every nation, hear the cries we bring now in the name of your beloved Son, Jesus, who is Lord forever and ever.
Our hymn for offertory is on your liturgy, 8 above all. Please join us.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Accept, O Lord, we pray, the prayers of your people, along with these sacrificial offerings, and defend those who celebrate your mysteries from every kind of danger, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for you will that our self-denial should give you thanks, humble our sinful pride, contribute to the feeding of the poor, and so help us to imitate you in your kindness. And so we glorify you with countless angels, as with one voice of praise we acclaim.
Holy, holy.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and from the world's beginning are ceaselessly at work so that the human race may become holy, just as you yourself are holy. Look, we pray, upon your people's offerings and pour out on them the power of your Spirit, that they may become the body and blood of your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, in whom we too are your sons and daughters. Indeed, though we were once lost and could not approach you, you loved us with the greatest love. For your Son, who alone is just, handed himself over to death and did not disdain to be nailed for our sake to the wood of the cross. But before his arms were outstretched between heaven and earth to become the lasting sign of your covenant, he desired to celebrate the Passover with his disciples. As he ate with them, he took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to them, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, knowing that he was about to reconcile all things in himself through his blood to be shed on the cross, he took the chalice filled with the fruit of the vine, and once more giving thanks, handed the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of your Son, Jesus Christ, who is our Passover and our surest peace, we celebrate his death and resurrection from the dead, And looking forward to his blessed coming, we offer you, who are our faithful and merciful God, this sacrificial victim who reconciles to you the human race. Look kindly, most compassionate Father, on those you unite to yourself by the sacrifice of your Son, and grant that by the power of the Holy Spirit, as they partake of this one bread and one chalice, they may be gathered into one body in Christ, who heals every division. Be pleased to keep us always in communion of mind and heart, together with Francis, our Pope, and Mark, our Bishop. Help us to work together for the coming of your kingdom, until the hour when we stand before you, saints among the saints, in the halls of heaven, with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, the blessed apostles and all the saints, and with our deceased brothers and sisters, whom we humbly commend to your mercy. Then, freed at last from the wound of corruption and made fully into a new creation, we shall sing to you with gladness the thanksgiving of Christ, who lives for all eternity.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may always be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you.
Let us pray. May the heavenly banquet at which we've been fed sanctify us, O Lord, and cleansing us of all errors, make us worthy of your promises from on high. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. A couple of announcements. This coming Friday, some of you all may have heard Pope Francis is going to be consecrating our world, particularly Ukraine and Russia, into the care of the Immaculate Heart of Mary. And that's going to take place at 6:30 in the evening in the city of Rome. And that will be 12:30 here in Nashville, so the middle of the day. And we're going to be gathering here in the church to pray the prayer of consecration together as a community. And the Pope is inviting the bishops throughout the world to do the same thing. So, a wonderful opportunity. If you're working somewhere and you can't join us in person, the parish will be sending out the prayer electronically to our parishioners. You can pray it wherever you are if you want to join us in that time of consecration. Also, this coming Sunday, the gospel is a story that Jesus tells that I think is one of the most powerful stories in the whole New Testament. So I'm going to give you a little quiz next Wednesday to see what you remember from the story, and I want you to think about what you learned from that gospel. What is Jesus trying to teach us in the story that he will tell this coming Sunday? So it's going to be a good one, and imagine, if you can, where you are in that story. The Lord be with you. Bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. Give to your people, our God, a resolve that is pleasing to you, for by confirming them to your teachings, you bestow on them every favor through Christ our Lord. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. The Mass is ended. Go in peace.
Here, take this one too, thank you.